This mini tutorial shows you how to view your unsatisfied requirements on Banner self-service. When you have unsatisfied requirements, you will receive an email instructing you to check Banner self-service for what they are. To do this, first go to mcneese.edu. If you're a current student, sign on to your MyMcNeese portal by clicking on the MyMcNeese tab and putting in your username and password. For a quick view of your unsatisfied requirements, click on the Student tab and then click on View Unsatisfied Requirements. You'll select the aid year and then submit. And here you will see your unsatisfied requirements. But for more details, you're going to want to click on Self-Service Banner. Before we go any further, let me explain how to log on if you're a new student not yet registered. Go to mcneese.edu, click on the Current Student tab, then under Registration, click on Banner Self-Service, then enter Secure Area, enter your user ID, which is your Banner student ID, and then your PIN number, and click submit or log in. Now that you're in Banner self-service, you will click on the financial aid tab. Among the links on the left hand side, click on eligibility. Select the aid year you wish to view, and then click Submit. This page displays the requirements needed for the applicable aid year, along with a short explanation. You should see your unsatisfied requirements listed first, and then requirements that have been satisfied listed below. Requirements can be either a document that you'll need to make a copy of and send to us, or a form that you'll need to fill out and submit, or even an action to take. An example of a document to send us would be a tax return transcript or maybe a copy of your birth certificate. If the unsatisfied requirement is a form that you need to fill out, the form should be hyperlinked to the requirement. Once you click on the hyperlink, it should bring you directly to the form that you need to complete. After you fill it out, you'll have to print the form to sign it, and then you can either scan and email it, fax, mail it, or drop it off to our office. If the requirement is an action that you must complete, for example, on a website, the website should be hyperlinked to the requirement. Once you click on the requirement, it'll take you directly to the site where the task must be completed. Other information found here are holds and academic progress. The holds tab only shows you holds on your financial aid. To view holds on your registration or maybe a hold on your transcript release, you'll have to go to the student tab and click on student records. The academic progress tab shows you the status of your satisfactory academic progress and your appeal if you had to submit an appeal to receive financial aid. Remember that unsatisfied requirements can show up at various times throughout the application process. They are there to prompt you throughout the process and guide you through each step required to receive financial aid. Also, if you're applying for both aid years at the same time, please make sure to view the correct aid year for the term applying for aid. For example, if you're applying for the fall 2014 term, make sure to select the 14-15 aid year. This concludes our tutorial of how to view unsatisfied requirements on Banner self-service.